sign of things. Diamond necklace, diamond rings. Fast cars, fancy clothes. Bad bitches, open toes. I just want to find the things. Diamond necklace, diamond rings. Fast cars, fancy clothes. Bad bitches, open toes. I like the way she walking in them heels.
Alright, what's poppin' to NB Gang? You already know who this. It's your girl May Beauty coming back to you with another video. And yes, as you guys can tell from the title above, I'm getting my first wax today, y'all, and I'm excited. Not only am I getting my first wax, and this is about to be a different experience, I'm here with my god sister supporting her business. And before I tell you guys the name of her business and everything she got going on, I'd rather introduce y'all to her and have her tell you guys about it. And don't forget to follow her Instagram. The link and everything will be in the description box down below at Jazz the Canvas Girl. And tell her I sent you, duh. Don't play with me. You better follow my god sister or else we won't fight. It's like, no.
She's about to go and get her wax done by me. Well, she's here. And, well, I got my setup or whatever. That's what's taking us so long. We're waiting for the wax to melt at the moment. I'll be showing you guys that, the whole little setup in a bit. Well,
it's cute too.
Yeah, it's all pink. I love all pink. Yes. So, the name of my waxing business is called Zaza's Blossom Waxing. You could go on Instagram, go on to ZB_waxing. You could follow me on Facebook as Jasmine Jingery, and from there you'll see more of the things that I put on there. Facebook page is coming soon for that. And also I have a website called ZazaBlossomWaxing.com. You can go there, book online, and also there's a $10 deposit which goes towards your service. So that means once you come, if you get a Brazilian, which is 65, you pay that $10 deposit when you make your appointment. And then the day that you come for your appointment, you just pay the $55. So, really affordable. I won't hit your head. I do deals. I give great gift bags.
Yeah. I got a free one just because.
Yeah. Because you're not got this. You know what I'm saying? So, let me just go ahead and show you the little setup while the wax is melting so we can get it all ready.
Yeah, let's go.
You go ahead. Fine. Here's my waxing certification.
Yep.
My name right there, and I got it on the 15th. So we're gonna place that here. Also, here's my wax. I use this wax, the Serapil. To me, I feel like it's one of the best wax. Everything comes off easily. You probably have to do only one cleanup after this, and then probably a few plucking if you're used to shaving majority of the time. We're gonna get to that as well. Let me see, and if we could zoom in on this wax right here. See, it's already melting and the beads are still on the top, but we're gonna get that off. We're gonna wait till that melts a little bit. And also, once it's done melting and it gets to the right temperature and the right place, I'm gonna go ahead and let you guys know for those who do want to wax or who do like waxing. I'm gonna show you what is the best temperature, because I know that's probably one of the big problems that some people do have. You don't want it too hot and you don't want it too cool. So we're gonna leave that right there. Also, let's come over here. This is before the wax. This is to sanitize your skin so that, you know, anything that's on your skin, even if you just took a shower, you probably put on lotion before you came here, which I don't recommend you to do when you're gonna get a wax. In the area you're gonna get a wax, don't put any type of lotion, shea butter, anything there. But even if you do, we can clean it off. Here is after you get your wax. It's kind of a lotion, you know, to make the skin soft, make it feel, you know, the pores are open, so you want to make sure that they don't get clogged up with anything. So it's very light on the skin. This right here is the after wax, complete after wax. It's that oil. That's that oil that make y'all glisten. Okay, y'all about to sit there and be shiny. Get ready for y'all bikinis, y'all little beach weeks and all that. So this powder, see the powder here, I use the powder for any type of sweat, body, you know, fluids, like I said, sweat or anything, mostly for sweat. because what it's supposed to do is dry up the sweat so the wax could attach to your skin and I could rip it off easily and it takes the hair right off. So then we're gonna go here. I have my gloves. I always put two pairs just in case I have to dispose. I have a pair of clean brand new tweezers. Then here's my sticks that I already took some out for. And here's the next pack. And I have some paper towel here to use for when I'm using these. So I'm not using just my gloves. And this right here is a panty liner. I know all women, most women, use panty liners after they're done. If they want to wear their own underwear, you know, even the powder or anything that's there. I know you're going to go home and take a shower. So I'll give you one of these and I'll also give you a disposable thong. So just in case you don't want to wear your underwear and you have on a dress or something, you can always have this on. It's optional. So that is that complete setup. Then you see here's my bed, which is pink, and I have my little disposable paper sheets on here. I definitely put in the trash after every client. Being sanitary is the best way to be. Your clients will trust you, they'll feel comfortable, they'll feel clean when you're done. You know, they wouldn't have to worry about when they come here if they're getting any infections or anything, which will never happen with me. Also, so guys, so see the wax has melted and all the beads are gone. There's still a little clumps in here, which is okay. You're just gonna have to mix it around and we don't want to make it too hot. So I'm gonna turn this down and I'm gonna go ahead and put the rest of these beads in here. As you can see, the beads, when I pour them in there, whatever is already melted. If the wax is too hot, you just pour the beads in like this. Okay, so you want to get all your beads out of there because you paid your money for it. So then we're going to mix those beads in here and you're going to see that they're going to start melting fast because the wax is already hot and it's going to start melting and we're going to mix and keep mixing until the wax is good. This part you're going to have to just beat up.
Yeah.
So they could just see how, when I'm mixing it, what it looked like.
And then she's using my favorite color.
Yes. Look at the blue. It's only really dark because it's all the beads at one time. But yeah, this is one of my favorite colors as well, but it happens to be Nika. So now that the wax is not that silky and not that drippy, you know, my wax is turned down, my wax warmer is turned down a little bit, so it's going to end up cooling off and getting a little bit thicker than this. There's some, probably a little bit of more clumps in there that need to be mixed up. We're going to go ahead and get back to you guys. We're about to get her all set up on the bed, on the table. So we'll be back. Tune in. No, it's okay. Cause Aaliyah's there. Thank you. Nope. Not this one. Alright, so here we go.
Alright, y'all, it's the moment of truth. I'm about to get things done. Like, y'all, finally, this quarantine, us being locked up, not being able to get regular things done or do certain things, I'm so happy. I feel good. I'm like feeling myself because I'm doing more things for myself than I normally would, actually spending money on myself. And she over here is working, but it's okay. Y'all, I'm so sorry if my lace looks crunchy. It's kind of like a lazy install, did not fix it, woke up and was just like, however it looks is how it's gonna work. Kind of ready to take this off, but I'm probably gonna reinstall. Yeah, girl. This is the first time, guys, my sister is like seeing my vagina, like vagina.
I am gonna be touching areas that may feel like dang, why she touched it, but it's because
that's
of
fine. Y'all, this is how we're gonna be when we get old. Like, if I'm in a diaper first, she's gonna be wiping me like this. This feels different. Like, guys, comment down below what your first time was like when you got your first wax. I want to hear y'all's stories. Like, let me know, because guys, I'm really taking you guys with me to the deep end. To the deep end. It's like,
nah. See what her pain's out for through.
Yeah.
And then when you get your sex.
We gonna see how that goes. Cause my first tattoo, it wasn't that bad. It was only bad when it got on my, literally on my collarbone.
Right.
That's when I was just like, cause it felt like a little irritation. Just, I felt it. And I was just like, okay, get off. Are you done? Yeah, it's just one letter. But I took that like a G. If I can take this like a G, I can take my thigh piece like a G.
Yeah.
Especially if he's coloring it in all like in one day. I don't know. Let's see how I deal with the outline. What are you trying to get your hair in a ponytail? I'm going to see how he does with the outline of my tattoo. Depending on if I get it colored in on the same day or not. But I can't wait. I will be vlogging that day for you guys. So I'm not even going to have y'all comment down below to see if you guys want that vlog or not. Because I'm already going to have it for you. And that's going to be another chill day with my sister. We're going to be lit. Guys, comment down below if you want us to start our God Sister channel. Like, comment down below if you guys are ready for that. If you guys want to see it like yesterday, let your girl know. And we will put in that work for you guys. We will get busy because we both are really balling. Like, we're going to have to do a story time of...
Because one girl is still pissed out for us.
It's cute though. Guys, me and my sis, we're gonna have to do a story time for you all on how we used to have our late nights in the car talking about where we want to be, and now that we're here starting our businesses and doing everything, it's nice.
Is it too loud for you?
Oh no, it's fine. Thought it was gonna be. Y'all saw my face. I was ready for that wax. I'm already here, guys, so I gotta, you know, take it. I can't back out now.
Yeah, you can't back out now. Because once that wax goes on, girl, it has to be removed.
Yeah, it's already here. It's already there.
Because if I'm going to be redipping, I can't contaminate the wax for the next client.
Mm-hmm.
But if there is a time where I'm using the Brazilian wax, the same wax for the same two different people, I just can't double dip at all.
Right.
And that's only to save wax.
The only thing that feels weird about putting the wax on is that when you're sliding down, you can feel the tug at the hair sometimes.
Yes,
because
that means it's drying and tugging, it's getting into the hairs now.
And I'm just like, oh my gosh.
And
like,
your hair's pretty thin, so it's going to come off pretty well.
If it feels like that when she's tugging and I already like just feel like, ah. I can only imagine when she rips this bitch off. Like, I love my sister, but I'm going to have to fight her after this. It's like, nah.
need you to move down a little bit. Like that.
Don't touch me. Don't touch me. Sis, don't touch me. Guys, I'm scared. Don't touch me. Okay. Oh my gosh. Yo, shit. Yo, yo. I can't. Oh. Yo. So y'all. I told
you to do that
because
that shit just came off smooth.
Y'all, it ain't that bad, right? But it's that bad though. Like, that sting for that moment is just like, why do we do this to ourselves?
I need it done. My niggas be wanting it done.
Ain't nothing less painful.
Well, I think there's numbing for you for like tattoos and stuff. But
not for. Like, shit, at this point, I'd rather go see what lasers feel like.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Okay. If you forgot, yo, this one is here, let me remind you. You're doing so well.
Yo, she fucking me up. And the thing is, we're gonna laugh about this in a minute, like when we're done. I feel like I'm clenching my butt.
When you're done with your lips, that's how you know you're almost done. So.
I don't like her right now, y'all. Right now, like in professional mode.
Like
that's what I'm saying, y'all. In professional mode, she not my friend. I don't know if I'm clenching in my butt cheeks or if they just feel stuck together because of the wax, y'all.
No,
like,
there's no wax there.
All right, I guess I'm clenching in my butt cheeks.
Dummy. Sorry if I'm hurting you.
A little bit.
With my finger? Right there? Okay.
Nah. It's just the tugging.
That part? Yeah. Sorry about that.
Ooh, he better like this. No.
Mm-hmm. Ready?
She ain't even let me answer. Damn. Y'all, I'm gonna have to, like, that's it. That's all y'all gonna see for now. Fuck speeding the video up. I'm gonna hit y'all up when we're done here. Okay, bye.
I'm just a wake up, you know? Our date.